time for a 5-minute deck tech, and this time it's with Sram Senior Edificer. This is one of the most one-dimensional cards you're ever going to come across. Of course, it's the backbone of a modern combo deck. Can we port that combo into EDH? Well, Onset Nonsense thinks so. They've sent in a list that is... wow, it is linear. You're going to see that this deck does one thing and one thing only, but it does it very well indeed. So let's get to it and see what this list is all about. For those of you not familiar with SRAM's usual MO, it involves playing a lot of zero-cost artifacts, which then just cycle, right? They draw an extra card thanks to SRAM's triggered ability. There are a lot of zero-cost artifacts. We call these the usual suspects here because they're the ones you see in the modern deck as well. Cathar's Shield, Bone Saw, Paradise Mantle. These allow you to burn through your deck for zero mana. But a lot of the other equipment, in fact, most of the other equipment, doesn't cost zero, so we have to find other ways to make this card draw free. And there are plenty of ways to do it. Helm of Awakening, Foundry Inspector, Cloud Key on equipment, and even Danitha here. These cards all turn the garbage one-drop equipment that has been cobbled together from throughout Magic's history into zero-cost equipment that draws cards with SRAM. So all of a sudden now, your Short Swords and your... New Rock Hover Sails are drawing cards along with your Bone Saws and your Cathar's Shields. But it's not just the static ability on these cost reduction cards that's going to help us out here. There's also an old modern favourite that we can port into this deck. Krark Clan Ironworks means that we can continue to generate mana while we're storming off with SRAM, and gives all of this garbage equipment another purpose. Not just drawing cards, it's now making a bunch of mana for us too. But it's not just SRAM that's doing the heavy lifting in this deck. Of course, there's his best mate, Pure Steel Paladin, which does more or less the same thing and actually lets you double dip on any of these zero-cost artifacts that you're playing. On top of that, Alhamrit's Archive is going to double the number of cards that you draw from all of those Bone Saws, and Mystic Forge does an impression of Experimental Frenzy, letting you go one card deeper by playing off the top of your library. But there's another really important card draw engine that I want to talk about in this list, and it is Skullclamp. Even though the deck only plays a total of 6 creatures, if you can get Skullclamp going in addition to Monastery Mentor, you are going to be buried in card advantage. And this is the only reason that this list can get away with playing 25 lands. 25 lands. That is the equivalent of a standard deck with 15 lands. Because of the velocity, because of the number of cards that you draw, you can actually get away with an obscenely low land count. I think the long and the short of it is, this deck does not have trouble drawing extra cards. The question is, what does it do with those cards once it's drawn them? Of course, there's a bunch of interaction in the deck. White has some of the best tools to manage the board in the form of things like Swords to Plowshares and Wrath of God. There's also tutors that are going to help you find the key pieces of equipment that you need. But what's really interesting about this little suite is that there are backup copies of all of these cards. There's Path to Exile, there's Day of Judgment, there's Open the Armory, so actually a fair bit of redundancy built into this list. One card, however, stands on its own with no other analog in this deck, and it is Mana Tide. There is no better feeling than getting someone with a Mana Tide. They tap out, you've just got a Plains open, and you just get them. If you've never Mana Tide someone, I tell you what, you are missing out. But none of these interactive cards are going to win the game on their own. For finishers, we have to go a little farther afield here. Well, how about Kemba, Car Regent? Have a look at this card. After you've drawn half your deck, you've got 50 pieces of equipment on the battlefield, you can slowly but surely start to plop them onto Kemba, and then at the beginning of each turn, you're going to create a bunch of 2/2s, and that's going to bury opponents very quickly indeed, unless they have an answer for Kemba, which they'll need basically on the spot to stop the onslaught from taking place. Monastery Mentor is another way for you to be rewarded for playing a natural game, playing out all of these zero-cost artifacts. Of course, the insane synergy with Skullclamp as well. This card is perfect for the deck. But if you don't want to contest the battlefield, how about Aether Flux Reservoir? You're going to be casting, you know, 10, 20 spells a turn anyway. You're going to gain a ton of life, and you can just start doming people. 50 for you, 50 for you, oh, and 50 for you as well. Don't even worry about it there like that. Failing that, however, you can just cast SRAM as a 2/2 and start equipping him with everything. He's got a Bone Saw in one hand, he's got a Leonin Scimitar in the other, a pair of Inventor's Goggles on his head, and he can just get him dead with commander damage. Imagine that. Assert your dominance, my friends, at your commander table by beating your opponents to death with premium 13th pick draft chaff. It's not often that you see an archetype directly ported from a competitive format into EDH, especially when, you know, we're playing here with singletons, but this deck does it in style. Sram Senior Edificer as this weird kind of combo deck that can also contest the board with Kembakar Region and Monastery Mentor. It's the perfect deck for anyone looking to do something a little different at their EDH table. Thanks so much to Onset Nonsense for sending in this list. You can find the full deck list at bit.ly/SramEDH. And if you want to submit your list as well, you certainly can on Twitter at Riley Quarry Tower. But that is that for this 5-minute deck tech. Thanks for hanging out with me, and I'll see you next time.